Right, I better go tell Jean then that, oh, nice. I can take that, apparently. So I shall. Hello.
Hail.
You, little asshole. Better go tell Jean that Driscara is visible again, if she hasn't already noticed. And then, we're done.
Any luck finding Driscara?
Yes.
Found him, did you? Well, I suppose that's good.
You'll have to forgive me. I seem to have misplaced something. Yes, well, let's never mind that. You've fulfilled your end of the bargain, though, so I'll fulfill mine. Romanus will have my recommendation. And don't you forget about me once you've finished your training. I'm sure we can help each other out.
Brilliant.
Take care.
Right. One down. Whole crap ton more to go. However, is Alchemy Lady about? I wonder. Wouldn't mind seeing her before we leave. See if she's got any more ingredients I can use. There she is. Oh, maybe she's on her way to the thing right now. What? Dude, what the hell the hell did you do that? You are a powerful magician indeed, madam.
It's my pleasure. Please continue.
Don't remind me not to get on your bad side.
Let's do business.
Well, have you got something in here that'll let me walk through walls, I wonder? Wow. Ring of Death. Dominate Humanoid. Summon Mithril Golem. Mirror Shield. Summon Daedroth. Silver Golem. Kill Potent. Phantom Frost, Winter's Grasp, Accelerated Rapid Fire, Rapid Fire 2 bolts per second for 50 seconds on self. Huh. Don't even know what that is. Kill, moderate, heal major wounds. Could do with that, actually. In fact, I could definitely do with that. How much is it? A fair amount. What else she got? Flash Bolt. Could be useful. Fortify health, ease burden. Already got something for that. Minor recharge. That we do need, actually. That could be useful as well, but we've got that other spell, so. Minor recharge, thank you very much. That heal major wounds.
Another satisfied customer.
Very satisfied, madam.
May I interest you in some of my fine wares?
Ooh, an apprentice calcinator. Or calcinator, or however you say it. Do you want? Am I still haggling? Oh, crap. Right, let's skip past all the bollocks. Let's get to the ingredients. Beef. We can make shield potions with.
You drive a hard bargain.
Ah, oh, Lady's Mantle leaves. Forgot you could restore health with those.
Bargain.
And aloe vera leaves. Not on the ball today, I'm afraid.
Bargain.
Cure disease. Grab it. I don't even have to mix that into anything, I can just eat it, apparently. Somebody was kind enough to point that out a few videos back, I believe. Rice, frost. Feather. Ah, Tinder Polypore Cap. Those were the things that let you go invisible. Love them as well. Soul gems too.
Thank you for your patronage.
No problem, Missy. Right. I suppose I don't need that anymore, do I?
You too.
I'm donated to the guild, even though I sort of stole it from the guild in the first place, but whatever. Okay, beef with potato, and with that. Wow, these are some nice potions. Was that it? I just want to add another shield ingredient. Never mind. Remove aloe vera leaves and this. And also this. Could do with some more restore magicka stuffs, but oh well. Oh wait, hang on a minute. That and the wormwood. Thank you. What does that do? Damage health. No, not interested. I don't know, I'm thinking of taking up poisons as well, but it just doesn't seem Idris's style, really. Fortify magicka, restore. Anything I can mix that with, other than that. Shock damage, huh? Wow. Nope, that looks like it's all for now. That calcinator made a difference, though. Actually, quite a bit of a difference, in fact. Should be on the lookout for better alchemy equipment, shouldn't I? Ah, yes, and, right, are you fully charged? You are, aren't you? Let's try something that's not fully charged. Oh, you're all fully charged. Isn't that wonderful? Right, well. Now you're not. So let's try this spell out. Minor recharge. 25% health, recharge 30%. Oh, right, okay, so you can only recharge the item up to 30% of its full charge. Makes sense. I understand. Right, well, that's still pretty useful. If one of them completely runs out, you know.
Good morning.
Let's have a look at our skills. The progression. Restoration is doing quite well. Alchemy again is set to increase. Conjuration, destruction, illusion. Illusion really need to pick up the pace with, but I don't have a lot of illusion spells. Mysticism. Let's, I need to do this anyway, so set you to 5. Hang on a minute. No, you to 5. How much did that increase my skill by? In theory, a fair bit. In theory, you see, that should increase my skill quite a lot more than the other little healing spell I had because of the magic mod. Like, the more powerful the spell, the more it increases your skill when you use it, which makes perfect sense, in fact. In fact, it makes so much sense that when I first got this game, I assumed that was the case. So I went around casting more powerful spells to train up instead of just the weak ones. I don't know, really. There really is nothing else for us to do up here, is there? In Bruma. It's a bit of a dump anyway. I'm sure Idris wouldn't mind getting out of here. And what the hell? Purple fire? And glowy noises? And what the? Okay. Idris, I think, we can only assume it must be some sort of strange local custom for dealing with the recently departed. Fucking bizarre. Nordic savages, a lot of them. In fact, now I really do want to get out of here. What's the time? 9:07 a.m. Plenty of time to get moving. It may have just started snowing, but who the hell cares? Let's leave. Get out of here. Go! Actually. Before we go, let's go head over to the Akdos Shrine and get a little magicka boost. Why not? Alright, where are you, Akdos? There you are. Thank you! It's cold. Right. Potion time. Where did I get those from? Oh yeah, the Mage's Guild. Have a couple of those. How much magic do we have in total now, anyway? 622. Goodness me, that's a lot. No wonder those potions don't seem to be doing a whole great deal. So, now, onwards to... Shaden Hall, I believe. It's the next point on our map we need to be heading to. I'm going to go around sort of clockwise, I think. Around this way. Though I don't know whether we'll do Breville or Leowyn first. I've kind of not really decided. I think maybe we might do a big long trip down all the way down the, what is it, the Yellow Road? Through the Nibbene Valley. At one point and get to Leowyn and then head back up to Breville and then go on to Skingrad and Kvatch and then Anvil. And do it that way. Yeah, we already read that. So, which way do we go? Right, we go this way and then head down right. And then, okay, gotcha. I didn't know if there was another road a bit like this one here. Like the orange road that led straight to Shaden Hall, but apparently not. Although we could go cross country. We could. It's a thought, isn't it? Well, we've had an early start. We've got plenty of time, so... You know what? Why not? Idris' old wanderlust is beginning to kick in a little bit. Let's head out into the wild yonder and see what we can find along our way. Might as well. We've got plenty of supplies. Oh, hello. Our first pitfall, quite literally, in a sense. Whoa. Oh, right, I can only go down now. Well, let me back up. Ooh. Whoa. Milk thistle. Is that useful? Light frost damage and cure paralysis. Not especially. Those I think are useful though, clouded funnel caps. I need to keep an eye out for them. You can make shield potions with them, I think. Unless I'm getting it mixed up with Summer Bolette. I can never quite remember, they look very similar. No, it's not these then. It's something else completely. Why do I have lots and lots of dryad saddle? Polypore caps. Makes no sense. Oh, they're worth a fair amount each, actually, mind you, so maybe I will hang on to them for now. I like the new redone grass for the sort of semi-snowy areas. With this, whatever this is, lavendery type stuff growing in it. What is this? Haestra runestone. No. Thank you. I'll be just fine without, I think. And I'm already lost. Where the hell are we going? Right, this way, southeast. Just try and point yourself southeast, Idris, and you'll be fine. God knows where you got your compass from, mind you, but there it is. God, the undergrowth here is thick. Tread deep on going down the hill. I love the wind sound effects, mind you. Right, whoa, hello. What's going on here? Namira's shrine. Yup.
Who are you? Why do you invade our place of worship? Surely, you don't think yourself worthy to visit Namira's shrine. A place of blessed darkness. A holy place where we may worship in our wretchedness. Why are you here?
In truth, I'm just passing through. I don't think Idris wants to worship Namira, so yeah, we're just passing through.
Then leave this place. Namira has no business with you.
I see. No, I didn't think so, somehow. Right. Well, that was a nice little curiosity. But a little more. Let's continue on our way. God, it must be chilly up here. Windy too, actually. Although the trees are probably blocking a lot of it. Hello. What do we have over here? A group of bandits hiding out in the woods. Now, here's a good opportunity to address something. Idris, since he... for those of you that bother to read the journal updates I do, Idris, you'll know that Idris has been having a bit of a little sort of internal conflict about, you know, what to do with himself in terms of... because he's got loads of powerful gear now. He's become quite powerful, you know, in more than he expected he would. And he's beginning to feel that... he perhaps has some sort of responsibility. You know, with the, you know, the whole spiel, you know, with great power comes great responsibility and such. You know, he feels he has some kind of responsibility to do a bit of good in the world, perhaps. As a, you know, as opposed to just sort of being indifferent to it all, because he has the power to do good things now. In, you know, very, very, very important good things, and he's worried that actually, on the contrary, he might even slip into doing evil things, because that's what happened to the last person who had all of this gear, you know, like those mad liches in the ruin, you know, they became completely insane with power, you know, so he's kind of, it's not a huge big deal, he's not getting really, really angsty over this, but it's something that's eating away at the back of his mind a little bit. Because these bandits, they could be outlaws hiding from the law simply, or they could be bandits planning to raid somewhere and kill lots of innocent people or something. And Idris right now, he has an opportunity to do something about it, and he's a little bit torn as to whether to leave them to go about their business because it's none of his business, or whether he should just stop them. And I think he's going to back away. He's not quite... No. It's none of his business. He doesn't even know what they're doing there. They might not even be bandits for all he knows. You know. They could just be... explorers, adventurers. Very much like himself. You never know, do you? And besides, he's just not ready to... I don't think he feels quite ready to go off... crusading about for the forces of good and stuff. He's not quite... Red Ruby Cave. Cave diving's not really on Idris's agenda, I don't think. It's more ruins are more his thing. I don't think Idris is quite there yet in terms of deciding that, you know, championing the causes of good... it's his thing. On the old Dungeons and Dragons alignment thing, he's still very much a true neutral. Possibly a lawful neutral, actually, now I think about it. You know. He doesn't care much for crime at all, in fact. Southeast. We'll keep going this way. And of course it's raining now instead of snowing because we're a bit lower down. What the devil? Okay, well, this time we don't have a choice about it, do we? Clearly. Cutthroat hedge wizard. Curse Kasei. Oh, I hate fighting on hills.
damn you!
Whew! Bloody hell. Go with that.
Ow!
For some reason, the game doesn't seem to want to let me power attack. I'm not sure why that is. But it is quite annoying. It just does this. See, look, I'm holding down the mouse button now and it's just held like that. Don't know why that's doing that. Oof. Ale, no. Onion, yes. Oh, God. You know what I've just realized? I have just realized that I have left all my books in Bruma. Oh dear! Oh dear, oh dear. Oh dear, oh dear, oh dear. Right, well, you know what? I'm going to fix this little issue. Because Idris would not have forgotten his books, even though I have. So, we're going to have to pretend this didn't happen. I will be right back. Okay, we're back pretty much around roughly where we were earlier. And now I have the books. And I'm happy to say it's a lot sunnier. In fact, it's the first sunny day we've had in quite a while, so that's nice, isn't it? Ooh, and there's Imperial City down there, through the trees. And, yes. As far as we're concerned, nothing has happened. Except maybe, like, it's got a bit sunnier.
Ow!
I so certainly did not have to fast travel all the way back to Bruma to get the books that I'd forgotten, because I already had them with me, of course. Or rather, Idris already had them with him, because he wouldn't forget them. Anything silly like that. No, it's not something he would do. Cough, cough. Right, anyway. I think we're on the right track still, roughly. Yes. There's been nothing other than really kind of just hills, isn't it, so far? I was hoping we might find something a bit more interesting. It's been hills and wild animals and hedge wizards, and that's kind of it. However, maybe this lot guarding something interesting, I don't know. Also, I can power attack again, which is lovely. Ah, little bugger. Stay still. Nice, lots of souls for the soul gems. Although I am a bit unhealthy. Oh, hello. Impling. You're dead, Impling, now. Alright, how's the charge on this doing? You know what, we'll wait till it gets lower, up to below 30% or whatever, then we'll cast that spell, and then we'll use the gems to recharge it up a bit further. That seems to be the most economical way of doing it, from my perspective anyway. I admit, I'm not the best at mathematics, but that makes sense, doesn't it? I'll leave it to you guys. Now then. This ground's getting a little more level as opposed to being on this freaking slope all the time. Now what? Show thyself. Whoa, hello. Whoa. What the devil? Skeleton. Kill it. And you. Another skeleton. Skeletons versus skeletons versus skeletons. Oh my god. Be gone, ghost. And you. You're actually really annoying me now. Well, I thought he was going to attack me then. Anything useful? No. The hell are we stumbled across here? Some kind of forgotten battlefield up here on the hills? Who knows? It doesn't appear to be a cave or anything around here, so, yeah. Your guess is as good as mine, people. was a settlement down here, though, apparently. I think I might have given up on this cross-country business a bit anyway, so let's just head this way. See what's over here. And just see through the trees. Oh, it's just like a cottage or something. Harm's Folly. It's locked. Well, we can't very well go barging into people's homes, so locked it shall stay, I'm afraid. Are these? Oh, carrots. Huh. Oh, wait, there's the owner. Greetings, sir.
Please, I implore you, help me avenge my wife's death.
What?
There are...
Oh, sorry.
Barely a week ago, I left Harm's Folly to go buy supplies, as I usually do once a month. What a fool I was to leave my wife alone. The goblins must have been watching me, as they knew right when to strike. I could hear Kayleen's screams from far away. Those wretched beasts killed her. Filthy animals. Had I only been there to stop them.
I'm sorry, Corrick. How can I help? Oh, I think, you know, I think I remember Variax commenting on this once himself. But I'm going to say it anyway. Yeah, the lack of choice here is kind of irritating. However, this is fine because this is a good point, you know, worth making actually, because Idris kind of decided not to bother those bandits back there, but you know what? Now, someone has come to him, you know, a wizard, a person of great power and whatnot, to, you know, help them, you know, because they're in need and they can't do anything themselves and they're in trouble and, you know, they need someone like Idris to, you know, help them or whatever. And I'm babbling slightly here, but the point I'm trying to make is that when duty calls, Idris will not say no. This man needs help, and Idris, the wizard, is the only one who can help him.
I'll tell you how you can help. Kill those things, every last one of them. They destroyed everything I hold dear. In their greed, the creatures grabbed a jade amulet off of Kayleen's body. Bring me back that amulet so I may use it to remember her by.
Very well.
Exhausted
good peasant.
Is not far to the southeast. Be careful.
Idris the White, complete with arrow in the shoulder. Shall ride to avenge your wife's death. Well, he won't ride because he can't afford a horse, but he will march, at least. Or stride in a very timely manner. That's what he'll do. He'll stride. Also, go away. Do not want random arrows sticking out of myself. Okie doke. Well, it seems we have a quest. One which actually is something worth doing, as opposed to this guild nonsense, which is really beginning to get on Idris's nerves. Especially after that last little incident with the... Ugh. Just, let's just not mention it either. Let's never speak of it again, I think. God, absolute inane bollocks, quite frankly. Stealing a guild head's book because of some prank, and it's all just a little bit beneath us, really. But this is a quest worthy of one such as I. However, worthy as I may be, there's also a bunch of goblins over there, and I don't have a lot of health. Or magicka, for that matter. Health can be rectified quite easily. Magicka, on the other hand, I'll have one of those, because of the shield effect. I'll have one of those as well. And we'll get ready to summon a couple of skeletons, because might as well get rid of these guys, even if they're not strictly the guys who are in the, you know. Ah! Though through steady practice, you have discovered more creatures to summon from the Plains of Oblivion. You are now a journeyman in conjuration magic and cast journeyman level conjuration spells. Excellent! It means I can also do this. Oh yes! I have a small army to do my bidding now.
Ow.
That's right, Gobbos. Idris and his army of minions have come to make your life a misery, because you freaking deserve it. Right, where's the last one? There you are. Where did you come from, you little bloody green-skinned ninja? Oh, I forgot this thing does timed damage. I probably shouldn't strike with this quite so often, just to get my money's worth out of it. Alright. Well, into the exhausted mine we go. To bring vengeance upon these foul creatures and stuff. I think Idris is quite enjoying this, actually. Shouldn't waste dagger charge on these things. That's what crap magic spells are for. Over-encumbered? What? What? Since when? Oh dear. Oh, that's been drained a bit because I'm sleepy, apparently. That's not good. 109. No, something else is definitely draining my... It wasn't that bad earlier. Ugh. Bugger. In a spot of bother now, aren't I? Right, I'm going to drop this for now. I must not freaking forget it, though. Good lord. Fire, frost, and lightning have flowed from your fingertips. You are now a journeyman in destruction magic. Cracking! I feel for a nap now, yes. Yes, apparently we do. That's not good, really. That isn't, though. Right, you know what? Let's just see what's in. Ah, we can't carry it even if we knew what was in there. Right, okay, here's the deal. Here's the dealio. Do I have a spell that could help me out here? I think probably not, but you never know. Right, you know what, we're going to do what I used to do when I played Fallout and I wanted to carry a bunch of suits of power armor back with me from somewhere but couldn't actually carry them because it was too heavy. What we're going to do, we're going to drop this. We're going to quick save. We're going to use the Z key and we're going to carry it along with us. This is a bit of an exploit, I know, but I don't have a freaking choice right now because there's nothing literally else I can drop right now. And this is starting to really annoy me, so... What we're going to do is we're going to head back up to this dude's house. Hopefully he's going to let us in. We're going to rest for a while. And get our strength back. And we'll just say to him that we scouted it out a bit and had a look. And we're going to go back and kill them all tomorrow or something. Because apparently Idris is absolutely fucking knackered. I don't know really especially why, but he just is. I'm not sure how I feel about this sleep mod, quite frankly, right now, but I won't uninstall it just yet. Right, can we... apparently we can't go in at the minute. Right, you know what, this is ridiculous. I'm going to say that we asked him if we could stay and rest in here. And the answer will be yes or whatever. I don't know whether or not I'll be able to give him a bedroll in here, though, mind you. Because, I think we're technically trespassing or whatnot.
Cannot sleep while trespassing. Yeah, there we go.
Cannot wait either. Yeah, I get it. Right, well, maybe we'll have to wait until he goes back inside or something. Dude, seriously. Stop your farming. Go inside. Thank you. What? Ah, you...
Get out of here!
Why? I'm helping you, for Christ's sake. Right, okay. Apparently, he's being a complete bastard as well. So, what we're going to do... is we're quite simply... going to have to sleep outside. Let me think. How can we rationalise this? This is ridiculous, isn't it, really? But hey, it's Oblivion being Oblivion. Right, okay, alright. I will say that we decided to sleep outside because we've offered to keep watch outside the cottage or whatever to make sure the goblins don't try and attack again or something. That's what we'll do. That's what we're saying. That's the official line. Okay? That's what's going on here. So, let's set up the old bedroll. Over here, we've got a bit of shelter from the trees or something. Yeah, good to see the bedroll in action now, guys, as well. I don't think we've used it yet, so... Nope, didn't mean to drop it. Well, actually, that also worked, didn't it? But it sort of didn't either, did it? Wait, yes it did, there we go. Okay, so... We can sleep in it. Apparently we need 10 hours of effective sleep. So that's what we'll do. And we'll set up very early in the morning to go kill the goblins. That should give us enough time for the rest of the day to actually get on our way a bit more, in theory. That was a good sleep. Another couple of hours, really. But it's raining! Fine. If the game insists I need another couple of hours, I shall have. Oh, for God's sake, go away, game. Seriously. Well, the stats are restored anyway now, so it doesn't matter. Right, yeah, by the way, guys, in case you didn't know, it was shift and action button to click up to pick up the bedroll. For anyone who's got this mod, I know, I remember watching Squee play this. Oh, Christ, I've been sleeping on top of... Maybe you've not on top of, but next to his wife's grave. That's a bit weird. I totally didn't notice that. I just thought it was one of the rocks. Crapo. Yeah, you shift an action button on the bedroll, and then you hit yes to pick it up. I remember watching Squeeze Let's Play where he was struggling to figure out how you actually do that when he used a bedroll, because he had the same mod installed as me, and I was screaming at my screen, you shift and click or whatever. But never mind. Future reference, anyone watching this is a bit bamboozled by that. They've decided to install the mods I put in the opening video for this LP. That's how you do it. Because I'm not sure if it was even in the readme or not, so there you go. Right, so, let's get on, because we have a job to do. I suppose sat there all night, looking at his wife's grave, certainly sobered us up a little bit. So you know what, let's freaking do this. These things need to die. They're a menace. And we're running kind of quite low on potions. We might have to make another... I think I suppose it's just as well we're headed to Leowyn after Shadenhall, because we'll need to go loot another load of bog beacon caps or whatever from down there. Right. In we go once more into the breach, my lord. And I'm going to... Where is it? Where is it? Where the bloody hell is it? Come on, there we go. That can be put as 8. Could do with a bit of light. Perhaps not for me, but for you, the viewers. Because I can see perfectly well down here, but I don't know about you lot. Ooh, carrion rats. That's a neat touch. Come to nom on the bodies. That's kind of cool. That is, actually. Do approve. Did I just kill one? Oh my god, that's so cool. You can kill them by walking on them. That's rather funny. Ha! Oh dear. Look at me, my wanton rat slaughter. Right. Yeah, first of all, let's open you up. Ah, there we go. Look, our encumbrance has gone up to 205 again, which is very nice, so... Where's the old spell? Minor latch crack. Wait, 10 gold. It cost me basically nothing to open that chest, so who cares? Apparently that rat wants to just run away instead of attack, so fine. Silver vein. More valuables for us. Well, these rats aren't hostile, so don't need to worry about them. Ah, these chaps, on the other hand, are a different story. Ha! Hooray! More souls. More souls for the old soul. What's it? How's the charge on this dagger doing anyway? Use is zero. Brilliant. Well, perfect opportunity to use that spell. Recharge added. Let's have a look. Soul damage 25% recharge. That, I think, will go away eventually. So I'm not going to heal just yet. I can't remember quite. It's been quite a while since I read the readme, so. Whoa, hello! There's quite a lot of you, isn't there? Okay, now we really do need to heal. And probably quaff that. Oh, you know what, Missy? Two can play at this game. In fact, to be precise, five people can play at this game. There we go. Well done, lads. Dog meat. Yes, please. No, thank you. Yes, please. And yes, please. Aha. Every little helps. I will not scoff at 15 gold. There will be a time when I need 15 gold, and I won't have 15 gold. So there you go. All right, chaps. Yeah, we need some more magicka, don't we? Hello, lads. What are you? Apparently, the archer seems to be the only one who spotted me. Right. That was a very small goblin. Not enough charge, eh? Well, we can soon sort that out. There we go. Right, let's have a look at the charge on this now. Use is 30. Oh, might as well use another soul gem. Also, just remembered, I need to get in the habit of using these instead of potions to restore my magicka, because they weigh a lot more than potions do. So I must try and remember that. Right, well, bone shaft. Ooh. That'll have though. Bloody hand shield. Right, that's, yeah, we've already gone in there. Have we? Yes. You're a toughie, aren't you? There we go. Now then, I did pick up that staff again, didn't I? Yes, I did. Good. Thank you for that. Would have been a little embarrassing had I forgot. Not taking that. Don't know how long that bread's been in there. Could be horrible. Could have been spat on by a goblin. Who knows? Not eating it, though. Exhausted mind spent works. So we need to get this necklace specifically, don't we? I mean, killing all the goblins as well is naturally going to be the prime objective here, but In order to actually, technically speaking, complete the quest, we do need to get the amulet. Still got a little bit of magic left. Let's steal Bardiche. Okie doke. Let's. Don't know about. That means cool. You know what? It's great. Let's have a look at it at least. I'm not going to take it with me. I just want to see what it is. Wow. That's kind of cool. It even looks quite good on the back as well, and like that spear in Mor Oblivion, which looked fucking ridiculous. Whoa, okay. Whoa! Oof. Okay. Well, you know, I mean, I said that naturally Idris is not used skilled in using weapons, so I won't be using them, but, you know. Since he was holding the thing at the time, I suppose. Whoa! You might as well have swung it at the dude. I mean, it can't take that much skill to just take down a stupid fucking goblin with this thing. Clearly. I mean, I don't even have blunt skill anyway, and I managed to kill them, so. You know. Seems fair enough to me. Now then. Do you have anything for me? And dead. Hello. Woo! Luck has been damaged. Why? What? By what? How's my luck been damaged? Did he use a poison, perhaps? Right, apparently we've got 4 more hours until we start getting really sleepy. That should be more than enough. In the meantime, let's use another welcome stone. I should almost hotkey these things, to be honest. But I don't think I've got any left. Well, I could use 7, I suppose, because Hindering Touch I never fucking use. There we go. And I should really cast this more often, too. But I have shield potions, really, which take care of it most of the time. Over-encumbered? By what? Oh, you burdened me somehow. Phew. I guess we just have to wait till it runs out then, in that case. Thought maybe I got a disease or something. Which would have been annoying. Or I'd been cursed like one of the Bone Walkers from Morrowind. Yeesh, I hated those things. I mean, they were creepy anyway, but just that annoying curse thing they could do was just... crown and glory of how fucking annoying they were. Hang on, that's restore luck, isn't it? And our luck's been damaged, so what the hell? Let's just drink it. Where's it gone? There we go. Very nice. Luck's back to 50. That was a bit random and lucky. I never ever used, I never used those restore intelligence or restore. Sometimes I use Restore Strength, just in case I get burdened or something, or, you know, a disease or whatever, but, I never use, like, the other miscellaneous ones, like Restore Agility and all that kind of dumb shit. But then, that was actually kind of useful. Minor latch crack. Go. That'll be getting me alteration skill up, if nothing else. Now then. 7, 5. Heal. Should really go delving for some more welkin stones, shouldn't I? Right, okay, you lot could be a bit of a problem. Epic music! Let me just go through this chest in the meantime while you lot keep busy. Whoa, okay. Maybe not. Ah. Okay, that was a little easier than I thought it'd be. That was one huge freaking silver vein. Whoa, what the hell happened down here? I have just noticed there are a bunch of Argonians in here. Argonian Conjurer. Ooh, have those. And those.